I follow it back and forth. This seems like a lot. What is going on, everyone? So I'm here today at Tailwater Outfitters, and I wanted to kind of sit down and talk about some informational videos with you guys, as it has been pouring pretty much all week around the Tampa Bay area. So I went on Instagram, YouTube, Facebook, and just wanted to ask you guys what kind of topics you want me to cover. And one of the most popular ones was for me to talk about reading tide charts and then using that information to kind of decide how I was going to go fishing that day and how that really affects different species of fish. So that's going to be a topic of today's video, is mostly about tides. It's one of the first things I check whenever I decide I'm going to go fishing for that day. I always check the weather as the first thing to make sure I can even get out that day. And if that checks out, then I always make sure I go online and check the tides. I use a couple different websites. I'll have those linked down in the description down below if you guys want to go check those specific ones out. Or you could just kind of do a quick little Google search and just type in your area and then tide charts. And it'll pop up with either the time frame, kind of like in like a little grid format, saying like the highs and lows for that day, and then the height of the water at that specific time, or show you a tide chart, which is usually this just like wave kind of chart looking thing. Will show you the times for the high and the times for the low. Check the tides in the morning, even the day before. A lot of these tide charts will be able to tell you even like weeks, months ahead of time. If you're really trying to plan a specific trip, you can look way ahead of time and just kind of get a general idea and really start mapping out what you're planning to do that day. Once I've gone ahead and looked at the tides, it really then decides what I'm gonna plan to do that day and also decides what time I'm going to go out that day. Let's say I kind of have a specific fish or a specific method I wanna go do that day. I'll actually kind of go off of the tides and decide what time I wanna go out. Let's say, for example, I was gonna go to use cup bait for redfish along mangroves. Typically with that, I try and shoot for the highest part of the tide of the day to go do that, because that's when the fish are going to be pushed up far in those mangroves, and I know that they're going to be up in that area anyway. So I'll go ahead, look at the tide chart, find what time of the day the highest part of the tide is going to be, and I'll actually plan my day fishing around that high tide. Or if you're the other way, you can just look at the tide chart and then decide from there, depending on your time frame that you can go out, what you can really target that day. Around our area, the most popular species are redfish, snook, and speckled trout, inshore at least. And depending on the tide, that will really decide when or where you can go to really target these fish. Let's say in the morning you have the outgoing tide, and you want to target some, or let's say you have a low tide in the morning actually, and you want to target like redfish or a snook. If it's a low tide, you know you can't really push up into the mangroves like you would on a high tide. So then you'll have to kind of decide, be like, okay, where is there going to be enough water and where are the fish going to be when it is that low part of tide? And typically that's in the deeper sections, maybe around docks and canals, stuff like that. Maybe some deeper potholes on the flats. Typically the fish will kind of funnel in there as the water is getting pushed out. Or maybe around some of these islands that have maybe some deeper sections there. You just kind of want to picture, once the water recedes, where these fish can still go. And my favorite areas to target these fish are around docks. If you can find a dock that still holds anywhere between like 2 to like 6 feet of water on the low part of the tide, especially if it has some current, then that will typically hold some fish, either some redfish, snook. It'll definitely hold some like sheep's head, snapper, and stuff like that. Typically what I like to do is give it about an hour window. So about 30 minutes before and 30 minutes after either dead high or dead low tide, and it'll tell you exactly what time that is on the chart. And typically around there, the water's not gonna be moving as much and the fish don't seem to be as active around those slack parts of the tide. And typically you'll find the most active parts of the day are on the moving part of the tide. When the water is really flowing, you got the bait kind of moving around, the fish following the bait and stuff like that. So really, the besides cup bait at high tide and like targeting fish specifically around docks and stuff at deeper water at low tide, you really want to be fishing around the moving parts of the tide. And that's going to be the biggest window for you, because it's about six and a half hours, at least for us around the area that I live at, where between your high part of tide and your low part of tide. Another important thing they really have to take into consideration is if you're going out to catch bait beforehand. And again, this is one of these situations where if you're going for greenbacks, for an example, either around bridges or docks or maybe even grass flats, the moving part of the tide is going to be the best. Slack high and slack low, they're not gonna be active, they're not gonna be moving around the flat. Even if you chum, you're not gonna have the most success. When the tide is moving, the water is flowing, the bait is gonna be moving around. So if you chum, it will kind of spread. And also when the tide's moving, the chum will be able to travel a distance either over a grass flat or kind of like through the pilings of if you're at a bridge or a dock or anything. Then it will really be able to travel a little bit further and cover more area to attract more fish. And they'll follow this kind of chum slick that you're making from your boat all the way to your boat and make it easier for you to throw your cast net or your sabiki or whatever you're using to catch your bait. Moving tides are your best bet, just as like a general rule of thumb for fishing. That's when the water's gonna be moving around the most, the fish are the most active. That's when you're gonna have your most success, even offshore. That's one thing I didn't really talk about. If you're offshore, tides do matter. That's when the current's gonna be flowing the most. And if you're on like a wreck or any hard bottom like that, you really need current pushing around to get those fish active. I've been out there catching fish like nonstop, and then that tide hits a slack part either at the low or the high and the fish will just shut off. And you know they're down there, but just a lack of the current really just kind of shuts them off completely. So even if you're offshore, tide is important and you need to check it to make sure that you're going out at the right time of the day. There's no point in waking up at 6 a.m. if it's gonna be not a good time to fish. You're better off, honestly, sleeping in or trying to catch more bait in the morning or something than getting out there and just wondering why the fish aren't biting. So yeah, check your tides, get an idea of what's gonna happen that day. Low tide, I typically look for the deeper pockets of water on the grass flat. You look for potholes around docks. If you got like a canal or something, some deeper docks or anything like that, it's gonna be your best bet. And then once it's incoming, you really, these fish are gonna follow the water up. So you're really gonna want to kind of push up with the moving water and the fish moving up with the water. So like I said, low part of tide, not a lot of water. Deeper potholes on a flat, we'll go with a flat for an example. As more water is coming up, these fish are gonna push further and further up on this flat, trying to look for these new areas of the water that weren't available to them before. And it's eventually gonna get up to the point where it pushes up to the shore, whether that be a seawall or a beach or mangroves, for example. So these fish will just push up with the water trying to explore that new area. So you can just follow, literally follow the water up and you'll find the fish like continuously moving up with them. So hopefully you guys found something about that helpful. That's just really my thought process that I use when looking at a tide chart to try and decide my game plan for a day to target specific fish. And if you guys found any of that helpful, make sure you give it a thumbs up on this video. I'd really appreciate that. If you guys want to see more videos like this, make sure you subscribe and I'll see you guys next time. This seems like a lot. No, you're good. And
I'm sorry.
No, you're good. That's hilarious. I follow it back and forth.